And who can forget Charlie Ward? Or Eddie George? How about Warwick Dunn? And the acrobatic one, Terry Glenn? But the Buckeyes and the Seminoles storm into the Big Easy with two of the hardest hitting linebackers in the game. The stars just keep on coming. There's the Big Cat, number 45, Andy Katzenmoyer. And for the Seminoles, there's the comeback kid, number one, Sam Cowart. Ohio State and Florida State are ready to light up the skies at the 98 Nokia Sugar Bowl. Welcome, everybody, to New Orleans. Good crowd on hand. It's the Buckeyes and the Seminoles. Throw one more log on the fire. Still a good one coming your way.
The winner will be number one when we start next season, and both these teams are loaded for next year. Both teams play a lot of freshmen, both true and redshirts.
There's one of the redshirts, Danny Stultz, their fine kicker from Orrville, Ohio. And the Buckeyes won the flip. They deferred, as most college teams do. You will see the talented Seminoles go on the attack first. Dean Feaster comes out, swings to the right-hand side, and he is down about the 24-yard line. We talked about quarterback Thad Busby, and now he backs it off. Travis Miner back in the shotgun, number 23. They fake it to him and throw it to E.G. Green on first down. Green slips Berry, comes to the sideline, and he's down at the 39-yard line. Talent galore out there. Green, Warwick, and Coles with that third receiver. Probably runs better than any of them. Miner, the freshman from right here, close by in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Carmichael, Whitaker, Long, Heaven, and Trey Thomas, number 70. A tackle spot. He's over on the right side through a cut block. Busby rolls hard, fire, too high, intercepted. Moore at the 38, up to midfield, and Damon is out of bounds, inside the 40-yard line. The Buckeyes with the game's first turnover. And the fullback, Keller, is set in front of Pepe Pearson, the familiar power eye. Miller coming to motion a little bit. They'll run Pepe in. Oh, was he jumped by that speed. There's Wadsworth. Bucks come up with a second down and long. That first down marker is across the 30-yard line. They'll try Pepe again. They'll pound the middle. Not much doing against that front. Julian Pittman. D. Miller, great year. And David Boston can bring it. We've watched Pepe Pearson. John Lumpka could get in there. But the focus is on this offensive line. Walter and Golston must keep the line of scrimmage clean. This is third down. The Gators did a magnificent job on Wadsworth. Coming on, Jackson. They throw over his head that time. They let him come upfield, but nothing doing for Keller. And you can see the speed. Spires, Johnson, Pittman, and Wadsworth. Something to prove. They did not do that well against the Gators. Cowart back from a devastating knee injury. Bush, one of the brightest linebackers around. The corners, they're okay. Over the Buckeyes, unable to move the ball. And Bartholomew hangs it very high. The Florida youngster will win all the way to Columbus, Ohio. He's in, breaks the plane, coming out on the 20-yard line. Buckeyes show blitz. Coles goes in motion. Busby gonna drop it over into Miner's hands. Miner slips more, could not get past him. And five defensive backs. And whistled before the snap. Part of the snap will indicate the same thing.
False start. Offense.
Now the Buckeye defensive front. Young, of course, no Vrabel, no Pincus this year. Rodney Bailey, freshman out of Cleveland, steps in there. There's the heart of this defense. Rudzinski, the big cat, and Johnson, who goes out for the nickel man. And Dan mentioned you're a nickelback, and there he is on the right-hand side. That's Central McClellan. He comes in to cover one of the wide receivers. Right now he is locked up on a slot man. Busby under pressure, caught beautifully, and Miner slips the first man before he's buried by the big cat on the far side. Now it's third down. They could use that inside draw play that they like out of the shotgun, but instead they're going to throw the swing to Miner. Miner could not get away from Damon Moore. And David Boston, a punt rushes on, but they couldn't get there. Boston Fields, 36, slips the first man, but not the second, and he's down at the third.
Illegal substitution on the offense.
And so Joe Germain will try the second series of the game. He'll be the Buckeyes quarterback next season. Wadsworth coming hard, steps into the pocket, fires to Pearson down the middle, wrestles it away, a big time catch. Third and one, you might see him for an option if the Buckeyes need it. Situational substitution, short drop, Germain fires too high. during the regular season. Who knows what Spurrier might have created. Looked like a broken play, and Jackson, with Coward hanging on, made his way to the 35-yard line. Wadsworth lined up at an angle. Can't be cut, jumps over the top. They throw to Keller, the fullback, and back they come. What great speed. Hayden played, wasn't offered a scholarship, and that's how the young man wound up playing for the Buckeyes. This one going into the end zone and coming out of the 20-yard line. Side. He'll frequently run out of this formation, but he has elected to throw again high, incomplete. Poles and
outside defense.
A lot so far in this first quarter.
A handoff inside. They run inside of Rudzinski, who took himself out of the play, and Miner up to the 47-yard line. They fake that handoff. Busby pulls it back out and hits E.G. Green. Green for another Seminole first down. Crosses the 40-yard line. As though he's going to pass protect. And Busby drops it straight back. Fires deep down the middle. Cowboy, what a great catch at the 11-yard line. Oh, baby, what a catch. Not one huddle yet for the Noel. Threatening for the first time. Here's Miner, wrapped up beautifully by number 32 that time. Lined up on that front like he's going to come again at this formation. Movement, but were they pulled by the nose?
Dead ball. Ball start. Offense.
Busby's back in that gun again. There's the end around on the reverse. They bring Coles, great speed. Katzenmoyer can't get him. Coles, end zone, Seminoles. But he may have just stepped out. He did step out. First down without scoring. Still back in the shotgun. Busby under pressure. Takes a hit. End zone. Down. Bullock got it.
Plummer's got the ball. An interception in the end zone. Number 19 with the pick.
Stanley Jackson in, and the Bucks are going to use two tight ends. They're going to ask for help against the front seven of the Noles. Pepe Pearson, nothing. They are getting whipped at the line of scrimmage. Bush, one of the smartest linebackers in college football. Jackson's got to run away from the pressure. One way, 25, 30. That's the best way to handle that pressure, is with the mobile quarterback. Who's gone there for 4 years and played. 67% have played in the NFL. That's unbelievable. And you can see Coward, who will second down and 10. Jermaine. Got Miller in motion now. Better job of blocking. Fires to the sideline. Boston's got it. To the 42-yard line, David Boston. Jackson re-enters. Keller and Pearson, Lumpkin and H-back. They'll power now with the fullback Keller. And he is wrapped up by number 45
with it right now.
Jackson fires to Miller, complete inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Got to keep the tight end down, especially on the Wadsworth side. They do this time. Nothing doing against that front. Rose in. Here's the hand to Pepe Pearson. Steps into the middle, and I'll tell you, you get hit so fast. I'm sure he was all over this defensive line after that loss in Gainesville. Third down and long. Shotgun. Jackson wants to take it off. Runs into the middle and keeps cruising. Just short of the 20-yard line.
Defense.
So after the penalty, it is third down and four for the Bucks. Jackson pulls it back, fires left side high, incomplete. Open to whoever. Stoltz will attempt a 40-yarder. Bartholomew, the punter, will put it down at the 30-yard line for him. And Garnett and Gold, the men wearing those colors, will try to come through and put some heat on this field goal. And the Buckeyes strike first. Dan Stoltz, the redshirt freshman, kicks a 40-yarder, and Ohio State leads favorite Florida State by a field goal. We'll continue with the Nokia Sugar Bowl. And what about Busby's two interceptions, one critical down. And the fullback Glenn checks in, and they move Busby under center for the first time. The middle screen, and Miner now is over to the right-hand side. And he's down at the 31-yard line forever and forever. And continuity is the way to win it. Now Miner from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, going to be a dandy.
And it's offside again against Ohio State.
Woodson, I want to tell you, that interception in the end zone on Leaf when they were trailing by a touchdown was huge. Busby completes one to Green, and he's hit by Whitfield. There, ladies and gentlemen, number 11, who don't break you down like that and make a tackle, let me tell you. Busby roll hard right, fire high, complete. E.G. Green again, very on him. There's Miner on that inside delay out of the shotgun, slips a couple of tacklers. Quarterback sneak. Had quite a long ways to go squaring up on Rudzinski, and he was flinching a little bit up there in that offensive line.
Dead ball. Full start.
Yeah. Right.
Offense. 5-yard penalty.
Busby. Fire left side, and it is complete again to Green, and he's going all the way for a touchdown. Berry and Winfield collide and eliminate each other, and Green just hauls it in for the evening's first touchdown. He whipped, and here's a fellow who won't whip, Sebastian Janikowski. What a kicker he is as he adds the extra point. E.G. Green with the game. First touchdown, and we bring down the curtain on the first quarter. Some moments to look at, two interceptions, but it was the front of the Seminoles dominating the game, bewildering the quarterbacks of the Buckeyes, wondering how to get help. But another interception saved him in the end zone, but not this time, and the Noles lead it 7-3. It's Wiley. He's going to have to hurry, and he's down.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Late hit on a kicking team.
See, maybe a draw, maybe a trap. Wiley in. Jermaine, the quarterback. Jermaine hit on the release, and he completes it to D. Miller. He's using a number of defensive linemen trying to keep him fresh. Like Wadsworth is out, Bryant is in. He was bringing the pressure. Jermaine steps away, deflected beautifully that time. Second down and 10. The Noles show a blitz. They walk a couple of backers up and quickly back them out. Wiley slips through, and there's that quickness as he picked his way.
Senior leadership tried to build a fire under them.
Let's see if Goldson can handle Wadsworth. He's coming on Jermaine again on the release and complete to Miller. Oh, is Jermaine hanging tough in the pocket.
Jump over Goldstein every time he tries to cut him.
Jackson in. Left side, complete to Lumpkin, the tight end. Basketball player turned tight end lineup. Here's Keller, the fullback. Green had him, nothing doing. Second down, Buckeyes will try to solve that front. Don't have a lot of time. Jackson's going to take off. This has worked before, and it will again. Stanley Jackson.
Incidental face mask on a defense.
Wiley away from the Wadsworth side to the 5-yard line on first down. Very small spacing on the Burris side. The direct snap to Jackson in the shotgun simply runs it. He is out of bounds. See if he can penetrate here on third down. Jackson's going to throw for the corner. Man not open. Boston was covered by Saunders. Against this defense, Cooper will settle for another field goal. Fake throw, touchdown. Great call by the Buckeyes as Lumpkin makes the reception on the Cooper call, but hang on. There's a penalty flag.
Unsportsmanlike penalty on the offense. Player coming on the field to deceive. It'll be a 15-yard penalty on the previous spot.
And Coach Blake used to slip him in from the sideline, throwing those long passes for touchdowns. Hold on here, we got a whistle again. And there was no question, because Cooper was pretty adamant that it should have been a legal call.
Offense, 5-yard penalty, repeat fourth down.
This is a 42-yarder. And we're pretty certain that Brett Bartholomew will not be thrown out of this formation. Bad snap, gets it down. Stoltz has to hurry, and he's not going to make it. The snap was not good, and that threw off the timing. And the Buckeyes misfire. As the Michigan Wolverines have put the capper on this one. Still a couple stories unfolding. Busby, pump fake, now going to go far down that far sideline, out of bounds. Preferred formation, shotgun for the Seminoles against the Buckeye defense. Freshman Travis Miner off to the left. Going to slip out of the formation. Here's the screen pass. He faked that he was going to block. So Busby standing back. kicks to the far side, high, caught, Coles, and out of bounds.
Dead ball, personal foul, defense, late hit out of bounds, 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, first down.
They have Coles down to the right. There's that handoff to Minor Red, beautifully though, by number 68, Winfield Garnett.
The handoff.
No huddle, Busby on the roll, crosses midfield. Miner is off to the left of Busby. No penetration. The flare, Miner, 45. With a 43, and in case you've been on the road and didn't hear on the radio, Michigan a winner, so they figure to wrap up the national championship. And out of the end zone. Against the pressure, down middle, intercepted. Picked off at the 45-yard line by Dexter Jackson, the free safety.
On Joe Germain, and this is the man. 16 sacks on the season for Andre Wadsworth. He gets help inside, and this ball is just up for grabs. Easy interception.
That, the handoff, the straight eye, and Miner. Outside toward the top of your screen. Busby looks underneath to Miner. Miner across the 40-yard line. Now it's third down and short for the Noles. They flare Miner. Busby looks and it's deflected incomplete. Number 94. And here comes Janikowski. This is a 56-yarder. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the great soccer players to come from Poland. High snap. He whacks it. But is it long enough? No. Was not. Snap was a little bit high. In a quarterback with Keller and Pearson set behind him. And Germain under pressure fires a diving interception. Picked off again by the Seminoles. Dexter Jackson did not have it. They're going to wave it off. Germain straight back. Here comes Germain. In trouble. Sprints to the left. Throws incomplete. Out of bounds. Columbus. Rips this one. Inside the 15-yard line. Great coverage. Down shy of the 20-yard line. The fullback basically a blocker. Far side high and dropped. Warwick had his man beat. He got beyond Plummer. Second down and 10. Shotgun, and here comes the blitz. Damon Moore is picked up, and they fire to Coles, who's wrestled out of bounds. Now Busby. Flair. Miner. Crushed. At the 22-yard line. Low, but it drove Boston all the way back inside the 25-yard line. Now he starts back up. Down at the 35-yard line. Three-point stance, gets ready to tee off against Golston. Reads the ball, forced outside. Jackson hit on the throw, incomplete. And Saunders all over Boston.
Pass interference, defense.
Wisniewski staying in at tight end rather than Lumpkin. Jackson stepping away from Wadsworth. Does, but then fumble. Let's see, they whistle it down. The umpire had whistled the ball down. Knows he did not play well against Florida. He has something to prove here tonight. Jackson back down. Down he goes. This time it comes free. That speed that the Noles are bringing out of here tonight. Jackson under fire. Gonna go down in a heap. At the 30-yard line, Tony Bryant. Bartholomew. Wales on it, and Warwick runs it up at the 34. Had a good shot at it, and he's out of bounds.
Disregard the flag. He did not have the face mask. He had the jersey.
They have featured the shotgun with Thad Busby playing his final game. Take the inside handoff, steps away from Rudzinski, under fire, short pass, and he's got his man Green. Green all the way inside the 10-yard line to the 7.
46-yard gain and still no huddle. Seminoles keep the pressure on. Here's the quarterback draw. Busby slides off the umpire to the end zone.
used the umpire beautifully off his right side as an additional blocker and just zipped on in for the touchdown. Wait till Fouts shows you this on a replay. Frey lead the way. And Janikowski pumps the extra point through, and just like that, it's 14-3, 325. He's a good-looking runner.
And he wants to use the combine workouts to raise his stock. I think he's doing that tonight.
I'll take Janikowski as a kicker on Sunday right now. Buckeyes need to ignite a rally here before the half. They could use a touchdown before they go in at intermission. Heppy Pearson, nothing doing. Watching him. Coming on the jump. Jermaine puts it into Pearson's hands and Coward. Suffered a cut chin, I remember in that game. Far side, high, incomplete. Double coverage over there. How much football talent in the state of Florida is. They should be declared illegal. It is unbelievable. Feaster driven back to the 20-yard line. To the 37-yard line. And that entire Michigan family. That's a great job. That Busby off the play fake, going deep. E.G. gets bumped, but nothing much doing to cut it. Busby fires incomplete. Oh, he had green, but of the 22 yards a catch. Shotgun look again. Busby steps away from trouble, and he is down at the 35-yard line. Punt by control. Strong lay, kicks it low. Boston heads hard to the right. And he'll be out of bounds at the 27-yard line. So they put Lumpkin over, a tight end this time on Wadsworth to try and block him. Jermaine got good time that time and hit Boston. Good job. Final 1:28. And Jermaine, near side, out of bounds. And so four men down for the Noles. The backers drop off, and Jermaine gonna have to run away from the pressure and dives.
Football MVP last year at this time.
Pull him back quickly. There he is, stepping away from the pressure. Fires a nice pass to D. Miller for a first down.
First down and 10, and Jermaine pulls it out. Bad pass. This could be six the other way. Kevin Smith. Pulled down by Boston from behind at the 22-yard line.
Three wide receivers. He looks toward Coles, who dropped it. Penalty flag is thrown.
He's up that time and sends offside. Coward. Bucks weren't ready.
On the defense. Lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty.
Minor goes out for Busby. There's an alley. Busby runs hard left. Throws. Caught. Out of bounds. So they load up the power look. Used the short man McCray for the touchdown. The freshman from Jacksonville. Big hurting put on by the Seminoles after that final interception, Dan. Didn't really whack it. Wait till the kickoff.
Thunderfoot. You know who he reminds
there
me
are.
Of?
There you are.
He reminds me of Morton Anderson a little bit, doesn't he?
Yeah, you know he does.
Left footer, big leg.
Must be doing well tonight. Here it comes.
He whacks that one high and deep.
Go out of the end zone and come out on the 20-yard line. Disappointed right now, but who knows what's going to happen in the second half. They'll have to solve that front better than that, huh? But somebody's got a chance to win $1 million here at the Nokia Sugar Bowl.
Minus 10 yards by Pepe Pearson. That's the biggest problem.
Jankowski thumps another one. Wiley says, let's just take it out on the 20-yard line. And man, what an astute young man he is. Jackson hands it off, and there's Pearson with his best run of the game. Angle, out an extra yard. Coward steps up between him and the tackle. And they run Pepe Pearson again. Try Pepe again on that isolation play without push in there. The Buckeyes might have found something. The fullback Keller right straight ahead. breaks it across midfield. This is Buckeye football. And the Buckeyes are trying to keep it going. Don't get off the run. Here comes Pepe again. Just keep pounding. That's what you got to do against great Rushman. Going to keep it right there with Pepe and nothing doing. He was jumped on the Wadsworth side. They put the tight end over there. Give Jackson the shotgun. He's going to run out of it. And they were ready. Smith, the safety. Big mistake. The Noles cross the scrimmage line. They're going to run Pearson slanting. And he got the first down for the Buckeyes. Good looking play. Buckeyes drive to the 37. Johnson back into the defensive line. Pearson goes right at him. Wisniewski with Lumpkin for the Bucks. Pepe gets a call, slides across the 35 to the 34-yard line. Jackson, Howard's picked up on the blitz, fires complete to D. Miller. Great pass under pressure for a Buckeye first down. Keller and Pearson. Jackson starts Lumpkin as an H-back. Howard to the left, and they'll run short side away, and Pearson's cut off. Number 95. Jackson with a penalty flag flying, going to throw the ball into the end zone. Whistle dead.
Dead ball. False start. Offense.
And Boston to the wide side of the field. Penny is the fullback, and they run Pearson straight up the middle. Inside the 25-yard line, Lumpkin gets down opposite Wadsworth. Toss play is to Pearson. Slant left side. Holds there. Pepe in a foot race to the 17-yard line.
So this is going to be a 35-yard attempt. Buckeyes lead this one down 21-3. They've given up 21 unanswered points. And Stoltz snaps that. 21-6. Now the Buckeyes need to come up with a little defense here at the Nokia Sugar Bowl and try to keep things going with Stanley Jackson. We'll be right back. Enjoying the riches out there on Bourbon Street over the weekend. Stokes pounds it. Kickoff. Stringer takes better of it because Feaster tells the gun to come out. They open with Glenn at fullback. They run the toss with Miner. Not much doing there. Number 95 was coming hard. Inside handoff to Feaster. Cuts back. Slips a tackle before Damon Moore brings him
down. After this play.
I love how he plays. Just a handoff down to Feaster again and nothing doing on the first down. Jack, think about this defense. Just think of who they play. Probably their best opponent under the board is their own team. Great play fake and Berry doesn't buy it. What a play by Berry that time. Pressure. Down he goes. The Big Cat, number 45. Here, they've already scored the field goal. Took the high snap, got it off. Boston gets 36-yard line. Buckeyes scored with the last series, running that iso play along with Pepe Pearson. Pounding away. And Pepe again. Running out to the 45-yard line like Seymour in a defensive end. The fullback Keller right straight ahead. And Jackson, of course, is the free safety. He has an interception. Toss now. Pepe looks alley-wise, crosses midfield, and across the 40-yard line. Oh, brings the play in, and he's the slot receiver. But they keep it right in Pepe Pearson's hands, and he is pounding away. Pearson, that time number 45, Lamont Green. He gets two fresh rushmen in the game. Third down, Jackson complete to Rambo, the freshman, but that is short of a first down. This is going to be a 46-yarder for Stokes. He represents the only points for the Buckeyes.
Pull this one to the left. And too far. Ball goes over to the Seminoles.
The quarterback next year when the season opens, no doubt for the Bucks.
Busby now with Miner back. Back to him, goes long down the sideline. Plummer couldn't cover the man, but a penalty flag comes down. Warwick makes the catch anyway. Here's Busby in trouble now. Rolling back in the end zone. It is. Did he step out? The safety. He did step out. No question. A safety.
50, and the Buckeyes are going to get the ball right back. Give Big Winfield 2 points. Did you hear that, perhaps, my friend? Guys Wiley inside the 10-yard line on one bounce. Sprints to the 22-yard line. They step a linebacker up. Put a five-man front. And that time they wail away. After about a yard, they pull Coward off a little bit. They expect the Bucks to pass. They don't disappoint. Another fires all over Jackson. Third down. Back now in that shotgun look. Keller right to his left. Jackson sprints left. Now fire. Oh, and Woodward. He's got it at the 22. Big Andre Wadsworth. Looking to strike from the 22 in the shotgun. Three wideouts go downfield. Bobby Bowden says, let's get it in a hurry. Throws underneath. Back in the Buckeye hands. Now Miner gives him four wideouts. Dump to the middle, Green incomplete. Berry with great defense.
Dead ball.
Yeah.
Personal foul.
You bet.
Offense.
Oh.
Dead ball.
Miller.
Personal foul.
Oh, right.
Defense.
Okay.
Offsetting penalty. Repeat the down.
Here's third down and 10 for the nose. Busby under pressure. Going to take it off. And we will continue with the fourth quarter after these messages and a word from your ABC stations. The native of Poland, grew up playing soccer, joined his father Henrik at Daytona Beach, and after his father came here to play soccer, and look how high he waxed that ball through for 3 points for the Noles. Regains three of the five, and we will continue with the fourth quarter of the Nokia Sugar Bowl. Leaded 24-8. Janikowski wails away again. And it'll come out on the 20-yard line. And 97 sacks. What a group of seniors. Jermaine returns, and on the release, and the Buckeyes will put a tight end Lumpkin over on him and run away from him. And here is Wiley behind Keller. Remember, Florida State was a nowhere team when he went down there. Jermaine blindside down. Held on to the ball. Blitzed by Todd Fryer. That is a high punt. Feaster back. 44-yard line and down at the 45. The future. As Busby is a blitz, they hand it off to Miner. Nothing doing down at the end.
Offers you the seat you'd like to have in a football game, folks.
Second down and 10. Busby fires. Third down and Busby fires. Oh, is that interference? I don't see a flag.
But Cottrell
in the punt. Taking down some high snaps, hasn't he? Causes him to hurry, and on it goes on into the end zone.
Tough hombre out of Mesa, Arizona.
Pulls it back, far sideline, got Boston open. Boston was out of bounds at any rate. Got fine, outstanding young official, and he was not happy with that. Jermaine is back, snaps it off high, incomplete. The back trying to get into his head. Reggie Germany is in at wide receiver underneath Miller. At the 25-yard line.
Oh, you're a hard man.
Here's the fake. Up the middle. Wide open. The short man. And that's Rudzinski, the linebacker. 10:07. And Buckeyes, let's see if they get a lift out of that. Jermaine's got Wadsworth in his face and won't get away. Andre Wadsworth. Keller, the fullback, Fryer couldn't get him. Forced out of bounds by the freshman corner. slips, tries to regain it, gets away, picks up a block, fires down a far side, caught, lifted, touchdown, Ohio State! How about that one, huh? All 6'8", the basketball player reaches down and makes an unbelievable catch off his shoe top, juggles once, and then dives and scores. Wow, what a play.
Heppy Pearson in at the tail. Jermaine looks right side, back of the end zone, incomplete. And they fail with the two-point attempt. The Buckeyes march in for their first touchdown on a great effort by Lumpkin. I'm out at the Nokia Sugar Bowl. They've been whittled to 10, but it was a big miss on the two-pointer. We'll show you some replays on the touchdown. And this conversion. Stringer, who is checked in, fields it at the one. Quick free. Stringer with an alley. Now the Noles will see what they can do about that time. At 8:44, they lead by two scores, up by 10. Miner stays in as tailback, and Busby going to fire it downfield on first down. And E.G. Green. Oh, brother, what a catch. Winfield all over him. First down. And Miners. Here's your second down. Buckeye shifted the line. And Glenn, the fullback, pounds inside the 20-yard line. Would not be unlike the Noles. Put it in Miner's hands, slant him, and he's not going to get it. Great defense. A 37-yarder. Hold it. Back to Poland.
I wonder if Janikowski didn't see Antoine Winfield coming in.
Dropped by the running back who had. Jermaine. And Pepe Pearson. Stanley Jackson will handle his third and 10. He'll sit back with his shotgun. He's going to try to run out of it. And nothing doing. Wadsworth will not let him have an inch. Beaster. 35-yard line, down at the 41-yard line. All the cameramen and technicians who brought you the coverage tonight. Here's the end around. Coles at great speed, and Moore wouldn't buy it. What a game he's played. Number 13 gets a 1,000 snaps. Here's Miner out to the 36. In other words, this year, Nebraska and Michigan would have met. Anyway, Busby fires, and Warwick got it out of bounds. At the 40-yard line, first down and 10. Here's the blitz against the run. Penalty flag is down. Miner.
Offside. On a defense. Lined up in a neutral zone.
You know, Sports Illustrated picking Penn State. Sporting News at Colorado.
They got to work hard.
And I'm going to play football, and I'm going to play at Florida State.
Miner is tripped up. So I guess he doesn't have to take the garbage out this year. Whatever. Busby off a play fake, fires into Warwick. Great grab
by Warwick at the 1 yard line.
That's William McCray, and he pops it in for his second touchdown of the game.
Illegal participation on a defense. Penalty is declined.
Can't even do it with 12 men, John. If you had this team, would you be concerned about that? Janikowski rifles in the extra point.
Cooper is just doing his Steve Spurrier imitation anyway.
Look at a big hug down there. Janikowski. 24 seconds. It'll come out on the 20-yard line. Joe Germain will wrap this one up. Next year's quarterback, there was movement. So the Seminole celebration has begun here on the near sideline. Last 40 seconds. Incomplete. Come across. They'll shake hands and start looking ahead to next year because this one's headed for the mothballs. Florida State wins the Nokia Sugar Bowl 31-14, and they did it very impressively. The Seminoles, the winner of the Nokia Sugar Bowl. Let's send you back to New York now.